Have you ever been called nigga or nigger by a white person and you were just baffled that they said that? And have you ever been called nigga by a black person and it didn't faze you at all? The Meanings of a Word by Gloria Naylor was the story that I chose. And in this story, she depicts how different words can mean different things to different people in certain situations. She mainly talks about how the word nigger can shift from a positive to negative effect in regards to how it is said and who specifically said it. She also talks about how words are innocuous, but it's the consensus that gives them the true power. In this story, Gloria also used a few anecdotes to show she had a personal connection with the topic.
You're a nigger. You're a nigger. Nasty fucking nigger. Public Enemy's song, I Don't Want to Be Called Your Nigga, fits so well with Claim 1 because as a black person, who would want to be called a derogatory name by a white person? Gloria didn't have a clear definition of what the word meant, but she had enough knowledge to know whatever it meant, he shouldn't have said it. So she didn't want to be called his nigger.
People, you ever had somebody call you, tell you they on their way, you call them back, them niggas still at home? Nigga, you said you was on your way, man. Nigga, my clothes in the dryer, man. Damn.
You'll never win. The power in the word nigga is a different sin. We shouldn't say it, but we do, and that's just what it is. But that don't mean that you can say it just because you got nigga friends. Nigga. That word was originated for you to keep us under. And when we use it, we know that's just how we greet each other. And when you use it, we know there's a double meaning under.
Joyner Lucas' song, I'm Not Racist, lyrics fit so well with Claim 2. Because over time, black people desensitized the word and completely redefined it. When we use it amongst each other, it isn't any hate or animosity behind that word. We use it to greet each other or have a sense of endearment towards one another. But normally, when white people use it, it's in a derogatory state. They use it to make us feel inferior, and it's so much hate and animosity behind that word.
That's the way it is. Come on, come on.
That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh yeah.
Hear me.
Tupac song Changes fits with claim 3 because Gloria said, and since she knew I had to grow up in America, she took me in her lap and explained. Meaning her mom knew that America was and is still racist, and no matter what, like Tupac said, that's just the way it is. Throughout the story, you could gather several themes, but the one that stood out to me the most was words do have double meanings, and it all depends on the context and who specifically said it. So in the song Let It Be by the Beatles, Mother Mary could reference different things. Paul McCartney had a mother named Mary who died. He could be talking about her. Mary is short for marijuana. Somebody could be referencing that. And also, somebody could possibly be talking about Virgin Mary. So like I said, words do have double meanings, and it all depends on the context and who specifically said it.